Is it about
that? It's a pain people with amputations may feel in an invisible limb. But Dr. David Burbrayer, a physiatrist at Sunnybrook, explains phantom pain is very much real.
The phantom pain is coming from the brain. It's a perceived impression, what we call an emgram. The brain has a picture of your residual limb that's absent.
Bruce Tompkins lost his leg when an infection settled into his bones and he developed an advanced stage of localized osteoporosis.
I was actually walking on six broken bones when it was finally diagnosed, and I only had really two choices: to live with the amount of pain that I was living in and not walk normal, or lose the limb and start a new life with a prosthetic, and I chose the latter, of course. There was a month at least where I went through a mental crisis saying, how can a leg that I don't even have cause this kind of pain, you know? The phantom pain that I get daily, which I still get, is just kind of a tingling and a numbing. Just allows you to realize that your feels like your limb is still there. But the severe phantom pain, I can only describe it as your foot being in a bucket of water with piranhas in it, or hot coals. It gets so debilitating that I've actually huddled into a corner and just cried myself to sleep because it just won't go away.
So how can you treat pain in a limb that doesn't exist? Experts say with a mirror and an open mind.
Mirror therapy is using a mirror between the limbs in order to allow the brain to think that the intact limb is the absent limb, and then allow a professional to treat the intact limb as if it were the absent limb.
And go.
If, for example, the toes are curled up and on the absent limb, as the patient perceives it, if they could move the toes on the intact limb and move it up and down, the brain will tell the individual that the toes on the amputated limb is now moving, and that will allow less pain and less discomfort in the residual limb. That's an example, and it works. It's effective in terms of treating pain.
And I had a full-blown attack on the Saturday night there. One of the ones that would have made me medicate myself and just curl up and just pray that it would go away, and about 20 minutes using the mirrors, it was completely gone.
But Dr. Burbrayer warns mirror therapy may not work for everyone. Patients need to be emotionally and mentally ready, willing to try, and persistent in using the mirrors.
It's going to be a lifelong process, but I think for now it's the results are fantastic. I'm not afraid of getting up in the morning and how much pain I'm going to deal with all day. I have a way to deal with it now that is working, and the more I work it, the more it'll work for me, and I'm not having a lot of phantom pain these days.
At Sunnybrook's St. John's Rehab, I'm Catherine Nasmick.